Hello, my name is Stephanie Naya. I am a student of the Pisaco Technological Institute. Class course Advanced English 1. Project name The Old Tree.
A long time ago, on a sunny morning, a beautiful little bird decided to stand on one of the dry branches of an old tree. While the bird carefully climbed its red plum, carried the tree away. How sad I feel before it was beautiful and leafy. Now I am branch of fragile branch. Who cares about a tree that does not bear fruit?
Why so much misery? Asked the little bird to the tree.
Well, you will see more than 2 months ago that the owners of this house left and says that they have no taste that drop of water. If it does not rain soon, I will surely die.
Oh, how sad. I would like to help you, but I don't know how. I am just a little bird. You think you can bring me even a supply of fresh water on your beak?
Sir, it is an excellent idea. I'm going to ask for help from all the bears of the course, and together we will fresh you.
Many local bears gather in the river, and led by the little red bear, they bring water for the old tree in their beaks.
Thank you, thank you, thank you very much, everyone. How happy and alive I feel.
Every day, the bears water the tree with great generosity. Little by little, the old tree recovered its color. Thousands of leaves grew again on the branch. The wall of it was again full of flowers that soon became juicy apples. The beauty and presence of the tree where he lived caused the house to be heavy again. Every day, the lady of the house watered the tree, making it look more resplendent. The happy birds of the arrival of spring and the happiness of the tree decided to organize a party in the patio.
No, 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 no. Do not stand on my branch. You don't see that you can't throw my leaves, my flowers, and my fruits. Look for another tree to jump.
The little bird bit, along with another bird, left very sad because of the attitude of their tree when they had helped so much. The next morning, a dove was trying to make its nest in the old tree. The tree, very angry, said,
"Hey, you don't see that you can't dive under my branch? There are many places where you can make your nest. So find yourself another place."
The dove flew away and sighed. Little by little, birds moving away from the patio and stopped and visited the tree. The tree continued to be beautiful and resplendent for a while, but every day it felt heavier. It had so many fruits and flowers on top that its trunk was beginning to lean. The lady of the house asked her husband to cut down the tree because at any moment it could fall. The tree that heard what the woman said to her husband cried consolably.
The birds hear the sound and come on the patio. "What's grown up tree? Why are you crying?" asked the little red bird. "I'm very sad. I did not let you throw away my flower or hit my fruits. Now my branches are so heavy that my strong husband and they are going to cut me."
"Don't cry, old tree. We are going to help you," said the little red bird. The bird began to throw the apples, flowers, and leaves from the tree. Little by little, the old tree strained off, and the lords of the house decided to not cut it down. Although for a time the tree only had a few leaves on the branch, he lived happily, surrounded by little bees, always thanking generosity.